So in the beginning, as I had promised yesterday, I have brought this book, Al-Biruni's Kitabul Hind. It's a big tome, no need to read, but I have given you the Xerox of the first chapter on the Hindus in general as an introduction to your account of them. It's the first chapter of Kitabul Hind. In this context, Hindus mean all Indians because it was the word that the people from across the Indus used to use for people from this side of Indus. ठीक है? So it's a beautiful chapter. आप इनको ऐसे ही कभी पढ़ सकते हो. It is not required for this course at all. It's a fun leisure reading, additional reading. ठीक है? So let me get that out first. Secondly, today's chapter is architecture. ये तो रूपा ने पब्लिश की है. रूपा, हाँ. बट द थिंग इज दैट्स नॉट द पॉइंट. किताब 1000 साल पुरानी है. इट मस्ट बी पब्लिश बाय मेनी पीपल, मेनी पब्लिकेशन. ठीक है? आई हैव द वन पब्लिश बाय रूपा. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन हु हैज ट्रांसलेटेड इट. देयर वुड बी मेनी ट्रांसलेटर्स ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ पर्शियन इन टूडेज इंग्लिश. सो कम टू टूडेज लेक्चर. बट बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस सेक्शन वी नीड टू हैव सम बैकग्राउंड, सम कॉन्टेक्स्ट, सम आइडिया ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. सो फ्रॉम टूडे विल बिगिन अवर लेक्चर्स ऑन आर्किटेक्चर. आफ्टर रिलीजन द सेकेंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन द सिलेबस इज आर्किटेक्चर. इफ यू गो बाय द अमाउंट ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट आर आस्ट, ऑलमोस्ट 35 to 40% क्वेश्चन इन आर्ट एंड कल्चर हैव बीन आस्ट ऑन रिलीजन. नेक्स्ट ब्लॉक ऑफ 20-25% क्वेश्चन आर ऑन आर्किटेक्चर. टुगेदर ऑफ दिस मेक ऑलमोस्ट 60% ऑफ आवर सिलेबस. नॉट बाई द एक्चुअल कंटेंट ऑफ द सिलेबस, बट इफ यू गो बाई द स्टैटिस्टिकल एनालिसिस ऑफ प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन. ठीक है? सो वी विल ऑल्सो गो क्वाइट डीप इन आर्किटेक्चर वन बाय वन फॉर एटलीस्ट 4 to 5 लेक्चर्स. बिफोर दैट, इवन बिफोर दैट, यू नीड टू हैव वाई दिस इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. सी, देर इज ऑलवेज अ टसल बिटवीन हिस्टोरियंस एंड आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट्स बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ दिम लुक एट इंडियाज हिस्ट्री इन अ कंप्लीटली, इफ नॉट कंप्लीटली बट लॉट डिफरेंट मैनर. देर इज वन ऑथर कॉल्ड जॉन के. हैव यू हर्ड ऑफ हिज नेम? जॉन की. ही इज रिटन मेनी गुड बुक्स. ही इज अ मॉडर्न हिस्टोरियन बट ही राइट्स अ वेरी पॉपुलर बुक और मेनी पॉपुलर बुक्स ऑन चाइना, ऑन ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, ऑन ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया एटसेट्रा. ही इज रिटन अ बुक नेम्ड इंडिया. अगेन, इफ यू गेट अ टाइम, इफ यू वॉन्ट रीड हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम एंशियंट मीडियवल मॉडर्न इन अ वेरी नरेटिव सेंस, इट्स अ गुड बुक. अगेन अ बिग टोम बट इंटरेस्टिंग बुक. रीड आफ्टर यू आर सिलेक्टेड. ओके. So John Key's book, he starts with this idea that a historian, when he looks at the past of India, he gets one pictures in the text material available, literary sources from Vedas, from Persian letters, from Tawariks and all, from Puranas, from Charitas, from Kavya, literature, whatever. So if you rely on text, you create an image of India's past, and that is one image. It has many problems, it has many good things, inconsistencies, whatever, you get an image. On the other hand, sir, please take these three handouts. On the other hand, if you look at India's past through another lens altogether, in which you do not use text, you look at artifacts, structures, monuments, coins, pottery, inscriptions, all these things. Are yahan dekho yaar sare log ले लेंगे वो. ठीक है? सो यू गेट अनदर पिक्चर. आइडियली व्हाट इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैपन इज दैट द पिक्चर दैट यू गेट थ्रू टेक्स्ट एंड द पिक्चर दैट यू गेट थ्रू आर्टिफैक्ट्स शुड बी ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर, बट इट इज नॉट नेसेसरीली सो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, GDP कैलकुलेशन, यू हैव वेरियस मेथड्स. डू ऑल ऑफ देम मैच? नो, देयर आर सर्टेन गैप्स इन बिटवीन ऑल द टाइम. लाइकवाइज इन हिस्ट्री ऑल्सो, यू हैव लॉट ऑफ गैप्स बिटवीन वेरियस सोर्सेस. Sometimes they corroborate each other, sometimes they don't. Corroborations are plenty, I won't give the examples of that. Sometimes you have only one kind of source for specific history or region. Take Vedas, you hardly have any artifact available, so you have to rely completely on textual material. You have various theories, whether this pottery is Vedic, that pottery is Vedic, that's just a theory so far. On the other hand, you have Harappa. You have only artifacts and you have no text. Whatever text is there, that is not deciphered. So you get other picture. Now it depends on who is producing those artifacts, the picture changes. For example, come to Buddhism. If I want to study the ancient Buddhist religion in India, how do I study? I go to Tripitaka's basic foundational text. I get an idea ki Tripitaka's ho Mahayana Sutra, Prajna Paramita Sutra or Lotus Sutra. I come to know, oh, these are the principles, these are the rituals, these are the tendencies, whatever. That is one level. On the other hand, if I go from artifact way, I see stupas, huge beautiful stupas. And then I see, oh, if stupas are so abundant and so imposing and monumental and beautiful, stupa must be a very important thing in Buddhism. But when I look at the texts, in the text, stupas are not even important. Many texts don't even mention stupas. Because for the doctrinal level, stupa is not important. Stupa is important practice in popular level for people. So if I look through text, stupas are not so prominent. If I look through artifacts, stupas are everything, primarily. And this disjunction. Because different people are practicing religion in different manner. The people who are writing and the people who are practicing at popular level are different people. Sometimes they interact, sometimes they coalesce, sometimes they contradict. All things happen. So historians and archaeologists struggle with each other to create alternative, if not alternative, some different picture of India's past. So far, historians have had the upper hand because of the tradition of Indology and school of history, etc. Archaeologists in the last few decades, a couple of decades, have started to come up with their own history of India through archaeological lens. Now we have books, history of Buddhism only through artifacts, history of India only through archaeological sources. We have many such books coming up in the last 20-30 years, big tomes. You get to know a different thing. There are many inconsistencies. For example, and even within literature, not only between archaeology and literature, even within literature, there are many inconsistencies. Take for example, the Persian sources in Persian Delhi Sultanate court written by official historians, Barni, Sijizi, etc. They give a court picture. On the other hand, we have popular viewpoint from the Maktubat, Malfuzat that we saw yesterday. Some of them call it, some of them don't. Take Manusmriti for example. Manusmriti gives you one picture of a highly caste-ridden society of inequality in some sections, not all sections, but in some sections. Very caste-ridden, inequal society. If you go to contemporary but creative literature of Kalidas, you have a different point of view. They don't match. They do match somewhere, they don't match somewhere else. So there are a lot of inconsistencies. Okay, the point is, when you look at India's past through the lens of archaeology or artifacts, you get a different and also very interesting viewpoint. And from today onwards till the end of the course, except for the last literature wala lecture, we'll focus primarily on this visual performative arts and artifacts. Okay, that is one thing. History of archaeology has its own history. Before the beginning of Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, in 1951-61, however you define it, we had many various administrators of British East India Company who used to do excavations, collections, curiosities. Then we have ASI, then ASI, Alexander Cunningham's lot of his famous stories. We have that John Marshall coming up. In between, we have many people coming up. Wheeler is there. We don't read that history because we read history written by historians and not history written by archaeologists and artists. So with that narrative, we are not exposed to. UPSC has asked only question once, that is John iske bare mein pucha tha, James Princep, decipherment of Brahmi in 1830s. 2-3 years ago only that question was asked. So only once UPSC has asked this question, and that is also from NCERT, so we don't need to worry about it. But just be aware that there is different, completely different segment altogether. Okay. Now come to the next point. Why do we need to study architecture? And how? Why and how? What does it signify? If I look at the past, stupa, forts, palaces, mosques, minars, what does it signify?
The economy of that.
Okay. Think of it from the point of view of person who commissioned it, patronized it or built it. Now we infer the economic conditions, I agree, completely true. But was that the primary reason?
Spread for particular ideology.
Ideology.
Make a center of teaching something, where people gather and exchange ideas.
Teaching center, yes. So it is a social context also, in which rituals, teaching, all things are taking place simultaneously. Let us say a temple. Temple is not just a temple where you go and pray. It is a cultural institution and a social institution. I agreed. Yes. See, but the thing is, let us take British, who built such Luton Delhi over here. What was in their mind at that time?
They wanted to leave a legacy, establish a legacy.
Legacy is, yes. So, once upon a time in future, there will be situation in which they will have to leave, and then after that they will leave their legacy. That is always true of powerful people. They want to get amar. That is true. But in the present, when they are building and after they have built, while they are still in India, what is the point? The prestige. Through huge monumental structures, you establish your prestige and legitimacy. Qutub Minar, prestige and legitimacy. We have come into India, we are going to stay here. And we are building a structure. Qutub Minar, an important structure. That is a statement, ideological, political statement, economical statement. Luton Delhi is a statement. Ashoka's pillars are statements. So, political context is very... British used to think that they are inheritors of the Roman Empire. 20th century Romans are them. So, उन्होंने उस तरह Roman structure, जो architecture को बहुत copy भी किया, उसको evolved किया, but nonetheless. So, strength and prosperity of the patrons you get to know. That is one thing. Second thing is, you also come to know from architecture, as you said, there is integration of various socio-cultural factors like arts. So, in Ajanta, if you go, you see there is a rock cut sculpture, rock cut architecture, cave. Do you know Ajanta? Ajanta. ठीक है, Ajanta. Actually, it is not Ajanta, it is Ajanta. But in English, it is called Ajanta. Werul become Ellora by British. Anyway, so Ajanta is not only a cave in which some religious people used to go and reside. You also have inside the cave, which is a very beautiful cave, you have firstly sculptures. And these sculptures are painted over. And what are the sculptures representing or doing? They are dancing, some of them. Some of them are very serene mudra, serene bhav on their face. Meditation. Some of the women are dancing, so they are dancing. How are they dancing? On some tune, some music. And the music is giving music to some drama or creative literature at that time. And they are wearing some beautiful ornaments and clothes in the city in front of some landscape. So you have that kind of city, village, landscape, ornaments, clothes, keshabhusha, hairdo. Woman figure dancing on song composed over something. So dance, drama, music, painting, sculpture, architecture, everything is together. So in India, we have integration of arts. It is very difficult to clinically separate them and study. Theek hai? So because it is not about the specific form, but about the expression of our manifestation of divine. The divine manifestation we will talk about in some time, but it is expression, integration of arts. We have various symbols in religions. Through the symbols, you come to know of their importance and their ideology, their messages. Like Triratna, for example, again and again I will use that. Then you have the changing patronage. That is the third thing I am talking about. The person who is giving money, his ideas or her ideas will dominate obviously in the art form, right? So for example, when a king commissions a stupa or a king commissions a minar, so minar is supposed to exhibit or manifest the ideas of king. तभी तो पैसे देगा वो अपने मन की तरह करने के लिए. But is king the only patron all the time? No. Take Buddhism only. Buddhism is the religion from where we see for the first time it got huge, massive patronage from its wealthy community of merchants and traders. So if you go to Ajanta, you go to Sanchi, you go to Karle, you go to Kanheri, everywhere you find lot of this. Small inscriptions talking about भाई मैं इस गांव से आया था, मैं इस जाति का हूँ, मेरा प्रोफेशन ये है, मेरे पिताजी का नाम वो है, एंड आई एम इन द रेन ऑफ सम किंग इन द थर्ड और फिफ्थ ईयर डोनेटिंग दिस. तो यू गेट सोशल इकोनॉमिकल ज्योग्राफिक बैकग्राउंड ऑफ दैट पर्सन एंड यू कम टू द पर्सन हैज डोनेटेड सम मनी फॉर रिलीजियस मेरिट एंड यू अर्निंग मेरिट थ्रू बिल्डिंग दैट स्ट्रक्चर और हेल्पिंग टू बिल्ड दैट स्ट्रक्चर इन पार्ट्स, राइट? सो इट इज नॉट ओनली द किंग बट ऑल्सो कम्युनिटी which gives patronage. And both of them give patronage to impress each other and primarily for the purpose of religion. So religion has always been a major stimulating force in the creation of teen adults, creation of Indian arts. Sir, ek ek lena sab jagah se, theek hai. But the point of interest over here is art is trying to create something in the manifestation, in the physical manifestation, which is actually a very illusory, imperceptible phenomenon. सब लोग यहाँ देखते हैं, यहाँ देखो यार क्या फर्क पड़ता है, कोई आ रहा है जा रहा है, बिकॉज आई एम डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर आईज. ठीक है, बोलो. ओके, दैट गेट्स लिटिल कंफ्यूज हो जाता हूँ मैं खुद ही, सॉरी. सो इंडिक थॉट इज दैट यू आर क्रिएटिंग दिस ह्यूज आर्किटेक्चर स्कल्पचर एटसेट्रा टू मैनिफेस्ट अ निर्गुण ब्रह्मन फॉर्म इन अ सगुण मूर्ति और टेम्पल और स्तूपा. स्तूपाज आर एट वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम सपोज टू सिम्बोलाइज बुद्धाज ओन बॉडी, शरीर स्तूपा. ठीक है, सो पॉइंट इज दिस अल्टीमेट ट्रांसेंडेंटल ट्रूथ वेन इट गेट्स मैनिफेस्टेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फिजिक्स, यू हैव थ्री बेसिक एलिमेंट्स विच हेल्प यू टू कॉम्प्रिहेंड दैट निर्गुण थ्रू सगुण. द फर्स्ट इज मंत्र, सेकंड इज यंत्र, एंड थर्ड इज मूर्ति. मंत्र, यंत्र एंड मूर्ति. आई एम येट टू स्टार्ट विद द हैंड आउट्स, ओके, आई एम जस्ट गिविंग यू बैकग्राउंड. सो मंत्र, यंत्र एंड मूर्ति. मंत्र इज इनकैंटेशन. मंत्रास वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन किस तरह सामवेद में हो, द वे यू रिसाइट देम, वो सब चीज़ें हैं. तो वील फॉरगेट मंत्र फॉर टाइम बीइंग, इट इज़ पार्ट ऑफ रिलीजन ऑफ प्रैक्टिस, उसको भूल जाते, वो अपना हो गया. ये यंत्र एंड मूर्ति, यंत्र इज नथिंग बट अ कॉस्मोलॉजिकल डिज़ाइन. यंत्र होते श्री यंत्र, सरस्वती यंत्र टाइप यंत्र होते हैं ना. सो आर्किटेक्चर of temples or stupa are nothing but inspiration of yantra. They are supposed to be yantra. They are microcosm of universe in that single structure. When we start temples or when we see some symbolism of stupa, we will come to know that this structure has some symbolic meaning, sometimes human body, sometimes the entire cosmology. Theek hai? So the sculpture may be, architecture may be temple or a stupa, it is a kind of yantra in itself. And then you have Murti. Murti is a sculpture that we all know. And through all these three things, these are physical parts which help an individual to focus the mind and then gradually draw inwards and then understand the Brahman. Ye basic concept ho gaya. Now because of this, because of the importance of religion in architecture, we see some specific characteristics that are emerging out of this architecture. Firstly, or sculpture, whatever. Firstly, primary concern is divine and bhakti. It is not the realistic representation of the society or nature or reality. So, there is a concept in archaeology or in sculpture called mimesis. You try to, actually you also can call it realism in one sense. You are trying to depict what is there in reality. So realism, materialism has got some another connotation altogether in the last 200 years. Parallel cinema type, realistic. So that is no more realism. That we use the word mimesis. It is mimicking whatever there in society or reality. For example, I want to show two people who are standing besides and both of them are of equal height. But one is the greater bhakt of some god, Vishnu, and other is not so greater bhakt. He is a minor character. Now, if I am a Western artist, what I would do? I would draw the one who is more important in a larger size, and the one who is less important in smaller size. Because he has attained more religious merit, he should appear bigger. Because what matters is not his physical real dimensions. What matters is the impression that I get in mind. So the message I want to deliver will change the proportions of design. the people who are more important will become bigger in the sculpture. The people who are less important will become smaller. The central collectors will be bigger. Secondary collectors will be smaller. So this is not trying to depict the physical aspects of the reality. It's about the religious message. If you go to Western art, they focus a lot on anatomical muscular realism. कैसे चिकबोन कैसे है, जॉ लाइन कैसे है. दिस इज द डिटेल, वेरी माइनर डिटेल इन विट दो वेल दे क्रिएट द क्राफ्ट. इंडियंस डोंट केयर. इंडियंस में क्या रहा है परंपरा से कि भाई व्हाट इज द भाव दैट दिस मूर्ति इज सपोज टू रिप्रेजेंट. शांत भाव, सीरीन भाव. सो हाउ टू अचीव दैट भाव. नो द पर्सन मे हैव लुक लाइक दिस इन रियलिटी और नॉट, दैट डजेंट मैटर. ठीक है. सो वी हैव अदर परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ लुकिंग एट स्कल्पचर, आर्किटेक्चर, साहित्य, संगीत, कला, एंड दैट इज अ रिलीजियस परस्पेक्टिव. And that's why the various devices that were developed in West, like three-dimensional perspective, these were not so developed, but that does not mean that Indians were less capable or less creative, not at all. But our creativity capability flowed in different directions and Western creativity flowed in different direction. That is the point. Theek hai? You will see through various pictures gradually. So it's not about facts of physical world, it's about facts of the other world. If you go to Sittanavasal, Sittanavasal is a cave in Tamil Nadu, a very famous Jain cave, famous for paintings. You see ki uske bhakt ke aankhon mein jo aapko dard dikhai deta hai, it is a very simple brushwork, standing between a lot of lotuses. But the impact that you get is so profound that even though his face might be unreal, doesn't matter. Theek hai? So emphasis was very much less on naturalism. It was much more based on spiritual message. That is the second point. Next, but that doesn't mean that art is only religious, right? Art is also in various forms. In the religious scenes, we have secular aspects, and we have daily scenes, daily aspects, non-religious art also in variety of forms. Now see, there are two different things. One is, who is patron? Patron is king or people or religious monk or whatever. Patron is different thing. The patron may be completely doing it for only religious purposes, for merit. But the things that are depicted in the art need not be only religious. They can be a variety of forms. And thirdly, the artists. So patron, artist and art are the different things. The artist also do not need to conform to that religion. If I am a Vaishnav Murtikar, I can still go to Buddhist stupa and help construction of that stupa. It's completely fine. Whatever is the symbol ultimately that matters. So I don't need to be of that faith to create that structure. So wo bhi diversity hai. Pattern mein diversity, art form mein diversity, and artists mein diversity. So religion, secular, dono intermixed hai yahan. Obviously, pre-modern world hai, hoga hi hoga. With that much of background, I think we can start. Let us look at overall idea of architecture first before going ahead. See, architecture we generally Harappa ka to alag se city hai, wo chhod do. Mauryan is also there, which we will partly see in sculpture. Majorly we will cover Mauryan sculpture. Apart from that, whatever is Mauryan, I will cover separately. But we start architecture from afterwards. So we have Mauryan. In it, you have most importantly pillars and capitals. You have other sculptures also. And then you have some palaces. Sculpture are of variety of form. You have stone sculptures, you have terracotta sculptures, etc. Then you have stupas. Initial stupas, the oldest core of many stupas you find belong to Mauryan era. And then your rock cut architecture that begins here from the caves of Barabar and Nagarjuni. Arkin. ठीक है, दिस पार्ट विल कवर इन स्कल्पचर. दिस पार्ट इज अ वेरी माइनर पार्ट, बुलंदी बाग, कुमराहार एटसेट्रा, विल टॉक अबाउट दैट, बट विल कवर प्राइमरली दिस टू पार्ट्स ऑफ मौर्य एरा, स्तूपा एंड रॉक कट. नाउ टेल मी, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्तूपा, चैत्य एंड विहार? ओके ओके, एंड व्हाट इज स्तूपा? ओके, यस, रिलिक्स, दैट इज एशेस आर रिलिक्स. ओके, एंड एंट्रेंस, तोरण, दैट इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्नामेंटल पार्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्तूपा, बट इट इज नॉट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्तूपा. दिस पीपल आर फाइन दैट इट कंटेन्स सम रिलिक्स इन साइड इट ऑफ बुद्धास, एशेस और समथिंग. सो स्तूपा दे आर नथिंग बट द स्ट्रक्चर्स टू वेनरेट द डेड. एक आदमी मरा हुआ है जो बहुत बड़ा आपका गुरु है, उसकी पूजा करने के लिए आपने उसका स्तूप बना दिया, समाधि स्थल उस तरह, लेकिन समाधि वहाँ नहीं ली उसने, उसके बॉडी के पार्ट्स वहाँ पे हैं. बट दैट इज नॉट ओनली व्हाट ऑल स्तूपा इज, स्तूपा गोज मच मोर बियॉन्ड दैट, विल सी इन सम टाइम, बट दैट इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ स्तूपा. सी, चैत्य विहार एंड स्तूपा, ऑल ऑफ देम एट दैट टाइम कुड बी रॉक कट और विदाउट रॉक कट. चैत्य, एज यू राइटली सेड, इज अ प्लेस वेयर पीपल गो टू डू सम वर्शिप, सम मेडिटेशन, सम पूजा. सो चैत्य गृह, सो गर्भगृह एंड चैत्य गृह, सो चैत्य गृह, प्रेयर हॉल्स, राइट. देन यू हैव विहार, विहार इज वेर यू स्टे, रेस्ट रूम्स, एंड यू हैव स्तूप, विच इज नथिंग बट द स्ट्रक्चर दैट यू वेनरेट बिकॉज इट कंटेन्स द बॉडी पार्ट्स ऑफ और रिलिक्स ऑफ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पर्सन, पॉसिबली और मे नॉट बी, बट विल सी दैट. यू समटाइम्स सी दैट यू गो टू अजंता इन द केव, your variety of caves are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 19, 20, 24, whatever. In some cave, there are some small cells made over there, where you see ki monks used to go and sleep over there. That is Vihar for sure. We have some major chaityas, where monks used to come and pray. But sometimes we have Viharas with some common courtyard in between, which has some small prayer hall. For the convenience of monks at that time, in the early morning or evening or in some parts, we don't have to go to next cave to do puja. But घर के बाहर, घर के अंदर एक पूजा का स्थान होता है, एक बाहर भी मंदिर होता है. So we have some small things inside viharas also for specific prayers. So there is a mixing of things. Anyway, leave that. Important thing is the chaitya is the one which also has stupa inside it. If you go inside chaitya, there is stupa. And it is stupa you pray, ठीक है. So that is why we call it चैत्य. Generally चैत्य के अंदर छोटा पत्थर का स्तूप बना होता है. So get this idea out of your mind that when you say stupa, it means only सांची का स्तूप type of structure. No. Okay. That is the point I wanted to make. So we will see the evolution of चैत्य and विहार when we see rock cut architecture. Today we will see only stupa. ठीक है, that is Maurya. When we see stupa ka development, we see it going through multiple phases. We need to first understand the concept and its evolution. Of it, the meaning, the concept of evolution of stupa. Then you have symbolism that we need to know, and thirdly you have structural elements of stupa that we need to know. UPSC already asked questions on all these three things in mains also. Fourthly, you have evolution of stupa structure in regional parts. Stupa began as a very small funerary mound, which is perhaps of pre-Buddhist era. Stupas were not the invention of Buddhism. Okay, Buddhism adopted the local stupa cult and made it huge and monumental and magnificent and beautiful. ठीक है, so we'll see stupa in all these things. Meanwhile, I have given you another handout of different categories of Ashokan inscription and their location. It's just a factual handout. It contains a map taken from Wikipedia and a list of all the edicts. I thought it needs to be given because people many times confuse between what types of edict. There is not only one type of edict. There are multiple types of edict. We have major rock edict. You have pillar edicts. You have minor rock edicts, etc. ठीक है. So नहीं, edicts is different, stupa is different. Edict is राजा ने जो कहा उसकी आज्ञा. ठीक है. Edict is given in the form of inscription. It can also be on paper. But here क्या है? It is here over in the form of inscription in Brahmi mostly. ठीक है. Come back to our stupas. We will begin with the stupa. I will walk you through the handout and show you photos over here. So far, any question, doubt, problem? मैं एक समझ गया. खाना जब बनाते हैं ना आदमी, यू हैव टू इनिशियली आपको सब्जी काटना ये सब करना पड़ता है, तब जब खाना अच्छा बनता है. सो अब तक हमारा वही चल रहा था थोड़ा सा, अब खाना बनाना शुरू करेंगे. ठीक, यहाँ पे हड़बड़ी करेंगे तो बाद में दिक्कत हो जाती है. सब्जी मोटी काटी है, ठीक से नहीं काट दी. चलो एनीवे, सी दीज आर द रिलिक्स ऑफ बुद्धास दैट वर फाउंड रिमेन्स विच आर इम्पोर्टेंट और वैल्यूएबल. दे कुड बी बॉडी पार्ट्स, दे नीड नॉट बी बॉडी पार्ट्स. ओके, इन द हैंडआउट आई हैव गिवन यू ऑल द इम्पोर्टेंट टेक्स्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड राइट द आंसर्स एंड ऑल द फैक्ट्स आर ऑल्सो ओवर हियर. हियर यू हैव फोटोज. ठीक है, ये भी आपको दे देंगे, डोंट वरी. आई नो दैट. सो बट द थिंग इज द फ्लो ओवर हियर एंड फ्लो ओवर हियर इज सम वॉट डिफरेंट, 10% डिफरेंट. सो आई वॉक यू थ्रू दिस ऑल्सो दिस साइमल्टेनियसली. जस्ट अ कलेक्शन ऑफ बंच ऑफ फोटोज, नथिंग एल्स, डोंट वरी. These are relics of Buddhas are found inside various stupas. They look like pearls. There is a whole research and debate why Buddha's relics look like pearls. So, जब हड्डी आप इतने समय जलाओगे तो क्या without because of that temperature and fire and does the part of bone turn into pearl or not? वो सब research चलता है, but we have found all these things in Buddha's relics. ठीक है, तो it is also called a शरीर और धातु. So, for example, this one is here in New Delhi. In National Museum in India. I visited National Museum. There is a separate hall for this. And whenever you go there, many Buddha, both the bhikkhus come from Myanmar, all across the world. They sit there in very silence and meditate in front of it. Buddha's body part are there. I never thought ki aise kuch main dekh paunga zindagi mein. This one. This apparently is hair of Buddha. Buddha ke baal hai wo. I don't recall kaun se stupa mein mila tha. Mostly. Some of them are in India, some of them are outside India as well. Sab jagah phaile ho. There is a story behind. I will tell the story. Wait for some minute, some time. Again, something in Myanmar. So, these Buddha ka relics were kept inside this kind of structure. These are called reliquaries. And inside reliquaries, these are put inside the under of the stupa. Okay. So, first you need to understand the stupa contains generally such relics. Now, this need not be of Buddha only. Okay, and this need not be body parts only. Suppose something is used by Buddha, that can be a relic of Buddha. Buddha's major disciples, they become great saints. Unke body parts can also be relics. There are some places which are very important in Buddha's life, where some important episodes or events from Buddha's lives have taken place. But there is nothing physical there over inside the stupa, but the place is important. You build a stupa over, it is called commemorative stupa. The word is stupas. If I am a bhakt, I go to Nalanda and there I, as a token of my visit, I donate something and I have a votive stupa. I build a small stupa over there just beside a major stupa. Also stupa. So stupas ke alag alag prakar hote hai. Theek hai? But these are the Buddha's body parts mostly. Now the story goes like this. That the tradition of building stupa is a very small funerary mound is come. There are 300 over here, take them one by one. As a small funerary mounds goes back to pre-Buddhist era. If you read some old authors like E.B. Havel, he connects it with the Vedic tradition also for some reason, I don't know. Most authors don't agree to that. Now people say that Buddha comes from Tarai region, Shakya area, Lumbini, right? And that is the region which is the Tarai region where people had these local cults of building funerary mounds outside villages near the tree trunk when somebody is dead. Aaj bhi gaon mein hota hai. So this is the tradition which Buddha inherited and then he made it big. But what we know for sure, either Vedic or non-Vedic, local or non-local, that is immaterial. One thing is for sure, that stupa building activity at a very minor local and very temporary level is pre-Buddhist. That is for sure. And secondly, therefore Buddha's relics become important because people wanted to create stupas over that relic. Thirdly, stupa building activity becomes a very huge art form and structural engine of Buddhism, not immediately after Buddha, but during the time of Ashoka, after a couple of centuries. ठीक है, तो अभी खोला था इसको, कोई नहीं, पहले चाय पी लेता हूँ. So that is, this is the picture that you will find in many Mathura art, Gandhara art, Amaravati art, where there is a person, a Brahmin called Drona, sitting at the center, everywhere. And what is he doing? Buddha has died in Kushinagar, right? And after he is dead, he is cremated and we have his relics. Now, what he had said at that time, distribute my relics across the people. Sabko de do thoda thoda. Everybody should get some part of Buddha's body. But what happened that before that could be done, the people from the neighboring principalities, chiefs, saat nagaron ke aur saat janpadon ke raja ne hamle kiye Kushinagar pe, mallon ke upar, ki we want also the part of relic. So ultimately what happened that this Drona Brahmana was appointed to divide the relics into 8 parts. Right? And each part was given to one kingdom or one janpada. So this is the picture which is very famous. Buddha is dead and you always see 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 somewhere. You have 8, 8, 8. So Buddha's relics are turned 8. And then there are certain parts which are not burnt, which were burnt, that is relics. Some parts which were properly burnt, that is ash, that is 9th part. And the vessel in which it was done, that is 10th part. So 8 parts of the body, 1 part of ash and 1 part of vessel. So overall 10 relics were prepared. These 8 plus 2 and they were distributed. I have given you a list of 8 divisions, which king got parts. In the early concept of stupa, 8 divisions of Buddha's relics: Ajatashatru, king of Magadha, Lichchavi of Vaishali, Shakyas of Kapilavastu, Bullies of Allakappa, Koliyas of Ramagrama, Brahmin of Vedapit Deepa, Mallas of Pava and Mallas of Kushinagar. So you have these 8 parts being taken. And on these 8 parts, supposedly Buddha's relics, stupas were built. That is one thing. Okay, sir, so far. Come next. This is the sculpture from Sanchi stupa's Torana, that is called architrave. That Torana has 3 lines like this, no? They are called architraves. Here you see the war of relics, 7 chiefs against the Mallas of Kushinagar. So, Hathi pe hai, Kuya pe ye hai, sab chal raha hai. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chiefs are coming, attacking Kushinagar. So, Buddha ahinsa bol bol ke mar gaya, uske marne ke turant baad hinsa ki Buddha kisko milega. Theek hai. Nonetheless, it shows ki bhai ek fakir kitna important hota hai ki wahan pe pure janpadon mein yuddha shuru ho gaya uske body ke upar. Dono taraf se dekho aap ise. So this is a very important episode from Buddhist culture. After 200 years, Ashoka says that I will take this ahead. Ashoka has many initiatives to his name in Buddhism. We'll see some of them today. One that we know right now here is that he supposedly built 84,000 stupas across India. Many of the Ashokan pillars are standing in front of once existing stupas which no more exist. Okay. So Ashoka said, I will collect all these 8 relics together and then redistribute it into 84,000 parts across India in each stupa. So he starts wars with all of them. Some diplomacy, sometimes war, whatever. He's trying to collect all them together. Out of 8, he is able to collect 7. The 8th one, he fails. That is this war. Ashoka visits Ramagrama. So here we have Stupa, Ramagrama Stupa. Here we have the 5th one, Koliyas of Ramagrama. That is this Stupa, out of 8. Here we have these people which were Nagas. So we have Vasuki and other Naga shelters over there. People are praying to the Stupa. They are bowing down. Here we have angels. It shows the Stupa is important. And here we have Ashok. It is on Sanchi, another architrave of another Toran. Okay, Ashok in his Ratha coming with elephants and archers and everybody and horses and trying to get it over here. And here we have many people praying and everything. Ashoka fails to get the 8th part of the Buddha's relics. Nonetheless, we don't know exactly what it represents, this part. This thing is not very clear. Iska matlab pura clear nahi hai. Still, the story goes like this, that Ashoka built 84,000 stupas across India and the stupa cult becomes important. Now, what we today see in Sanchi or other places, very few of that goes back to Ashoka era. The stupas built by Ashoka are either broken, dilapidated, do not exist, or built over. Some of them were built perhaps with the help of wood. Some of them were built with bricks and they are built over with stone now. Some of them got dilapidated, whatever. So some stupas do not exist. Some stupas have Mauryan era ka core inside them. And some stupas, if they belong to that era, they are very oldish. They don't look attractive. So at the time of Ashoka, stupa cult becomes important, but it doesn't become as beautiful. It becomes beautiful in later era, after Maurya, in the two important regimes. One is Shunga and other is Satavahana. The Shungas and Satavahanas embellish stupa with a lot of fine ornamentation. Okay, that is the next stage. Now, before coming to the stupa, its variety and everything, there is a story. Ashoka also went on Dhammayatras, Dhammayatra. He used to go, like Badshah Akbar used to go to Ajmer every year for almost 10 years. Like with Ashoka, used to go on Dhammayatra. So we have some elements which tell our story. This monk Upagupta. Now this story is, I don't know how true it is, but there is a story. Upagupta used to guide Ashoka across Buddhist center. This is a map of India at that time, of Buddhist heartland of India. So, and this red line indicates the line road on which Ashoka went, the sequence. So what we will do here, we will go in the same sequence and visit all the stupas one by one, which are important, which Ashoka visited, and then come back to the origin, and then we will start a stupa study. Theek hai? I think it is interesting enough. So we have this Ganga, Yamuna and Prayag. You have Patna over here, Odantapuri, and you have Gandak, Ghagra, Gomti coming over here, Chambal, various places. So we will not go to all the places, we will go to some of the places which we know that Ashoka had visited for sure. This is Lumbini. Lumbini is in Nepal. So I had told you that joke already, Buddha Nepali hai ki Bihari hai. Theek hai? After that I went home and I found there is another video by Dalai Lama, and Dalai Lama is saying that Buddha is definitely Indian. I know I am telling Buddha is Indian. So Dalai Lama had to answer the question. So Lumbini is the place of birth, that is called Jati, the birth of Buddha. We have a stupa. Yahan Maya Devi temple hai piche, ek purana. UNESCO already said to hai. Now China has built a lot of things over there, new stupas and all these things. It's just across the border of India. Then here Bodh Gaya. Bodh Gaya is the place where Buddha gets enlightenment. Ashoka went there as well. We don't have Ashoka's structure at that time. We know that Ashoka might have built something there. What we have is this structure which is built in Gupta era. And it was also dilapidated. But it has surrounding it this small Vedika or fence that goes back to Shunga era. Shunga era comes after Mauryan. So Shunga helped build this, then it got dilapidated, then Guptas built it. This is the 5th century plaque which shows that how this stupa must have looked like in 5th century. It is Mahastupa, it is Mount Meru. It doesn't look like a typical stupa. You can call it Mandir, call it stupa, doesn't matter. It looks like Mount Meru. It is over here. Today it looks like this. It again, koi bahut bada tufan aaya tha, toot gaya tha. Alexander Cunningham had a lot of role in preserving it. Then sometime Burmese people came and they rebuilt it. So it went through various phases. Today it looks like this. It is UNESCO World Heritage Site again. When Huizenga had come to India, he described Bodh Gaya as the center of the Buddhist world in 7th century. Just Huizenga comes in the era of Harsha. just after Gupta's 7th century. Then Ashoka went to Sarnath, Mrigadeva, Deer Park, Mrigadeva, where Buddha gave his first sermon. We know all these stories already, right? So, isliye ab thoda jaldi you will be able to comprehend. Stupa over there. Look at the stupa. It doesn't look like a typical Sanchi stupa. That is my point. Not all stupas look like that. Please mind that. It is a brick stupa. Dhamik stupa. Then you have Sankisa. This Trayastrimsha, 33 Amsha, it is a name of heaven in Buddhism. Buddhism has various heavens. One of the letters is Trayastrimsha. It also has some name in Pali. The story goes like this: after Buddha gave the first sermon, after Dhamma wheel starts rotating, he starts from gaon to gaon, shahar to shahar, giving the sermon. In the course, along the while, he also goes to the heaven. भगवान को भी मैं सरमन देके आऊँगा, किसको नहीं छोड़ूंगा. तो ही गोज इन टू द स्काई टू द गॉड्स. हिज मदर इज देयर. मदर एक्चुअली अशोकास मदर डाइड इन चाइल्ड बर्थ आफ्टर 7 डेज ऑफ हिज बर्थ माया दी. सो ही वॉन्ट्स टू मीट हर मदर, हिज मदर एज वेल. सो मदर एंड गॉड्स, हाँ अशोकास नहीं, सॉरी बुद्धाज मदर, सॉरी बुद्धाज मदर, थैंक यू. सो बुद्धा गोज टू द स्काई, ही प्रीचेस द गॉड्स, ही गिव्स देम धम्म चक्क पवत्तन सुत्त. Talks to his mother as well, and then he comes back. The place where he comes back to India, descent of Buddha back on earth, is this called Sankisa. There also Ashoka built one stupa. UP. Yes. You have this map, no? Sankisa. Down of Ayachhatra, between Ganga and Yamuna. So you have Mathura over here, Delhi over here, Ayachhatra over here. You have Sankisa in Panchal region. ठीक है? You will get these photos, don't worry. Then you have Vaishali's Mahastupa. Vaishali, you know the story of Amrapali. Vaishali, Nagarvadhu of Amrapali. The famous rich merchant Ananda Bindaka comes from Vaishali. So Buddha visited Vaishali many times. So you have stupa. This stupa doesn't exist anymore. But layer 1 mud, layer 2 brick, layer 3 Kushana period. So we have initial part, which is of Mauryan era. Then outer core of Kushana era. Now everything is destroyed. Ravages of nature. Inside that you find this. Again Buddha's relics. Then finally you have a place where Buddha was cremated. That is the Ramabhar Stupa in Kushinagar. In the back here you have this old Hiranyavati river. So Lord Buddha on the banks of the river Hiranyavati, Kushinagar. And after this they show that there is a place. I have not visited, so I don't know, I read it. There is a place where this Buddha's relics were divided into 8 parts. I have heard the story, it still exists. People show it around, like local guides perhaps. I don't know. This Mahaparinirvan, Buddha is reclining. It is a murti of much later era. So, still reclining Buddha. Theek hai? So, you have this Dhamma Yatra of Ashoka. Dhamma Yatra become important. The second point over here is, now stupas are built not only where his relics are present, but also in the places where some event had occurred. Take for example Sanchi stupa. Sanchi Buddha kya kiya tha? Neither there is a relic in Sanchi stupa, the great Sanchi stupa, nahi hai Buddha ka. Nor is there any important episode or event associated with Buddha that happened in Sanchi, wo bhi nahi hai. Sabse sundar stupa Sanchi mein hai. Kyun bhai? Koi batayega? See, Sanchi was on the very important trade route at that time. So it is an important town jahan pe people come and go, mercantile trade hota hai, log aate hai, paise hai, sukoon chahiye. So patronage wahan pe available hai. Geographic location is important. Theek hai? And secondly, when Ashoka had not become the king, when he was still a Kumar, he was the governor of this central region. The headquarter was in Ujjain, Odisha, that region. So he spent his youth in that region. One of his 5 queens, Devi, the earliest queen, was his girlfriend, Ashoka. So Ashoka had spent many days with her girlfriend, with his girlfriend in that region. So uske shayad ho sakta hai. It is a rational guess given by many historians ki wahan pe stup banaye kyun itna bada Ashoka mishra mein. To perhaps jawani ke din usko yaad aate honge wahan pe uske. Theek hai? Point, we don't know, just a speculation. Theek? But Devi has a very important role in Ashoka's biography, not to be taken lightly. So come to back to stupas. So let us come back to the handout. the stupas and the early Buddhism. Initially, relics of the Buddha were enshrined in the solid cores of stupas, which become places of veneration and pilgrimage, Dhamma Yatra, pilgrimage. Soon, relics of the Buddha's disciples and famous monks were similarly enshrined. Not only Buddha, but his disciples as well. For example, in Sanchi, we have multiple stupas. One of these stupas contain the relics of Mahamoghallana. Also, the stupas were built at places related to the key events in Buddha's life and career. Now, the important point comes. Veneration and worship were transferred from the relics to the stupa itself. Whether or not it contained the relics. Tab stupa hi object ban gaya puja karne ka, gradually over centuries. The stupa swiftly became an emblem of the Buddha's Dhamma and an important part of Buddha's Buddhist monasteries. Now come next. As the importance of stupa grew, so it did its function and meanings. In addition to being considered the living presence of the Buddha, his protective powers and living energy, they were also a site of rituals and ceremonies for Buddhist upasakas and monks. Their presence eventually attracted other constructions, including monasteries around stupas. Now, initially you have these pilgrimage stupas. So I have made them two bold words, pilgrimage stupas and monastic stupas. So initial pilgrimage stupas we don't find anymore, they are lost. And then we have bigger patronage coming in, and along with that the Sangha order is becoming prominent, and we have monasteries associated with stupas. So we have monastic stupas. Ye initial classification shuru wala ho gaya unka. However, come to the other important categories of stupa. You can categorize them in multiple ways. As I said, Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, in 1860s-1870s, who had a huge role in conservation and preservation of Indian architecture, huge role. So he divided them into three parts, Sharirika, Paribhogika and Uddeshika. See, it is not going detail. Question that can be asked generally is, in UPSC kya puchte hai? Stup ka matlab kya hai? Write a note on symbolic meaning of stupa. If you don't know what stupa means, how can you write a note on symbols of stupa? UPSC has already asked this question. Sharirika, or in MCQ stupa means A, B, C, D. Relics se alawa sab kuch galat nahi hota hai. Isliye, theek hai sir. Sharirika, Uddeshika, Paribhogika. So, Sharirika is the one which contains the relics of body. The second contains other relics which are not body parts. Jaise maine koi kamandalu use kiya hai, koi danda use kiya hai, koi thali use ki hai. So, all these paribhogika aspects of monks which are important, monks who are important, they are paribhogika. Equipment, accessories, etc. Sharirika is body part. And then you have Uddeshika. Uddeshika is वहाँ पे कुछ हुआ था, यू हैव सम उद्देश्य, ठीक है. सो द प्लेसेस एसोसिएटेड विद बुद्धाज लाइफ, सो उद्देशिका स्तूप. एंड देन फाइनली टू दिस लेवल वी एड वोटिव स्तूपा. वोटिव स्तूपा मीन्स व्हेन महायान बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट, पीपल स्टार्ट गोइंग टू पिलग्रिमेज एंड विजिटिंग, देन दे ऑल्सो बिल्ड समथिंग देयर, जो मैंने अभी बताया था. सो छोटे छोटे स्तूप बनेंगे आसपास, तो देयर वोटिव स्तूपास, डोनेशन देने वाले स्तूपास. ठीक है. टू द लिस्ट वी हैव वन मोर स्तूपा, दैट इज सिंबॉलिक स्तूपा. नाउ सिंबॉलिक स्तूपास आर नाइदर कंटेनिंग एनीथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट इन इनसाइड, नाइदर दे कोमोमरेट सम स्पेसिफिक इवेंट एज सच, एंड नाइदर दे आर बिल्ट ऑन द प्लेसेस विच आर रिलेटेड टू हिस्टोरिकल सेंस ऑफ बुद्धा और बुद्धिज्म. But they symbolize some thought, some idea, some belief. For example, you have various Kalachakra stupas in Tibet later on. Symbolic, they symbolize Kalachakra. You have in modern times peace pagodas. In Hiroshima, if you go, I'll show you a photo. Hiroshima, you have a peace pagoda. Right? In Ladakh, you have built peace pagoda. So there are message there. Hai. So that is symbolic. Symbolic message aap convey kar rahe ho. So you can build stupa there as well. Right? So you have these varieties of stupas. Is it clear? कुछ मुश्किल लगा अब तक, कुछ अलग लगा अब तक, सब कुछ ठीक है? नाउ कम बैक टू, दिस इज वेयर आवर नॉर्मल टीचिंग स्टार्ट्स, दिस स्ट्रक्चर राइट। एंड बाय लुकिंग एट दिस स्ट्रक्चर यू सी हो स्तूपा मीन्स लाइक दिस, विल गो लिटिल बिट। ये टॉप व्यू है, ये फ्रंट व्यू है, दिस इज सांची का ग्रेट स्तूपा। इट इज ओनली सांची का ग्रेट स्तूपा बिकॉज इट इज प्रिजर्व्ड इन द बेस्ट फॉर्मेट, वी टेक इट एज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव, बट इट डज नॉट रिप्रेजेंट ऑल वैरायटी ऑफ स्तूपा दैट आर अवेलेबल, बट इट इज बेस्ट प्रिजर्व्ड एंड वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑल्सो। सो लेट अस टेक इट टू अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म्स असोसिएटेड विद स्तूपा स्ट्रक्चर। लेट अस ज़ूम इन। ई स्तूपा इन द हैंडआउट आई हैव गिवन बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्तूपा, तीन फंडामेंटल पार्ट्स होते ही होते हैं। वन इज अंडर, सो दिस इज अंडर, ठीक है, हेमिस्फेरिकल पार्ट। सेकंड इज द हर्मिका, दिस इज हर्मिका जो स्क्वायर होती है ऊपर। एंड थर्ड इज छत्र, ये ऊपर जो छत्र है। सो यू हैव दिस थ्री पार्ट्स विच विल बी प्रेजेंट इन एवरी स्तूपा इन सम फॉर्मेट मोस्टली, लेटर ऑन छत्र भी चला जाता है लेकिन ठीक है। बाकी ये वेदिका है, तोरण है, नहीं है, उष्णिष है, स्तंभ है, सोची है, दीज आर ऑल रीजनल डाइवर्सिटीज, दे मे बी प्रेजेंट प्रोमिनेंटली, नॉन प्रोमिनेंटली और अब्सेंट, ठीक है। इफ यू इन साउथ इंडिया इफ यू गो यू हैव सम न्यू एलिमेंट्स कमिंग अप, विल सी देम, दे आर नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर एट ऑल, लाइक आयका पिलर्स। सो मेडी सोपान, नो टेल मी वेर इज द डोर ऑफ द स्तूपा, दिस इज द डोर, सी दिस इज तोरण, सो यू हैव फोर ऑन फोर डायरेक्शन, ठीक है। सो इफ आई एंटर थ्रू तोरण आई कम ओवर हियर इन साइड द रेलिंग, सो यू हैव अ रेलिंग दैट इज वेदिका, इफ आई गो थ्रू तोरण आई गो इन साइड वेदिका, बट हाउ डू आई एंटर स्तूपा? सुबह का डोर कहाँ पे? देर इज नथिंग, नो वे यू कैन गो अपवर्ड्स, जा नहीं सकते ऊपर, सीढ़ियाँ नहीं है। एग्जैक्टली, देर इज नो डोर, यू कांट गो इन, इट इज अ सॉलिड अंडा, यू कांट गो, यू आर नॉट सपोज टू गो इन साइड, यू आर जस्ट सपोज टू गो फर्स्ट ओवर हियर एंड जस्ट डू सर्कम एम्बुलेशन प्रदक्षिणा पाथ एंड कम आउट, दैट्स ऑल, गो होम, ठीक है। वेल डूइंग सो यू एट द रेलिंग्स एवरीवेयर यू सी ऑल ऑफ स्कल्पचर्स, ऑन दिस स्तूपा यू सी स्कल्पचर्स एंड दैट ऑन दैट यू हैव स्टोरीज। सो प्रदक्षिणा करना ही एक आपका रिलीजियस कर्तव्य है। However, there is some inequality here as well. If you see over here, you have one pradakshina path on the ground. And if you go inside, you have this Vedika and then Medhi, you go upwards. And you have at one higher plane, second, first floor pe, one more pradakshina path. So you have two pradakshina path, ek niche, ek upar. Upar wale ka adhikar kiska hai? Only the monks who are spiritually superior can go upwards and then they have pradakshina over there. Common people, lay folk, upasak, you and me, will do on the ground floor. ठीक है, सो दैट इज द बेसिक थिंग। देन यू हैव वेदिका, यष्टी, तोरणा, दीज आर एडिशनल फीचर्स, ठीक है। दिस इज जनरली इन मेंस, इफ दे आस्क क्वेश्चन, स्टूडेंट्स लाइक टू ड्रॉ दिस फिगर, तो इसकी प्रैक्टिस करके रख दो, निकाल सकते हो आप आंसर में चाहो तो। यू शुड बी एबल टू ड्रॉ दिस नॉट इन डिटेल बट जस्ट अ स्कीमेटिक इन 30-40 सेकेंड्स। Look at this evolution of stupas. Mauryan era simple mound till Kushan era, which has this Harmika Chhatri in the format, this format. So this is the initial or early stupa evolution. Later on, from stupa, as it goes to Central India, from Peshawar, Central India, Tibet, China, Japan, it becomes pagoda. So gradual evolution of stupa is taking from mound to stupa, from stupa to pagoda over 1000 years gradually. Pagoda is nothing but stupa. Pagoda pata hai, Japan mein hote hai gaane wagera. Suna hai pagoda na? Theek hai, this is called pagoda. They are generally wooden, yes. Yes, and you can go on each floor. They are very beautiful. Now we go to regional tradition. We have seen the typical structure, symbolism, okay. I have a box over here. On the page number 4, we will see that the great stupa, that is stupa of Sanchi, in the box at the bottom on page number 4, is replete with cosmological symbolism as well as being the central symbol of Buddha's parinirvana, his death, right? So, I have given a few points over here from book published by Oxford. तो उसमें उन्होंने स्तूपा के स्ट्रक्चर का सिंबॉलिक मीनिंग दिया है. सो इफ यू आर आस्क्ड अ क्वेश्चन द सिंबॉलिक मीनिंग ऑफ स्तूपा, यू डिवाइड आंसर टू पार्ट्स. फर्स्टली द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्तूपा, व्हाट इट मीन्स सिंबॉलिकली, दैट इज गिवन ओवर हियर. एंड सेकंडली विच विल कवर इन स्कल्पचर, दैट इज द सिंबल्स दैट द स्कल्पचर्स ऑन स्तूपा डिपिक्ट एंड मीन. सो वी स्टडिंग स्तूपा इन टू पार्ट्स, वी विल रिविजिट और वी विल रिविजिट दिस स्तूपा एंड वी स्टडी स्कल्पचर्स. ठीक है, अभी बस उसका स्ट्रक्चर देख रहे हैं. दिस इज मीनिंग, आपको पढ़ लेना है इसको, सिंबॉलिक मीनिंग ऑफ, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग. कम टू द रीजनल ट्रेडिशन, वील विजिट दिस पार्ट्स. दिस इज बैरात, विराट नगर इन, लुक एट द मैप ओवर हियर, बैरात, विराट, विराट नगर मत्स्य देश, पांडव यहाँ गए थे. ठीक है, राजस्थान. यू हैव ओवर हियर सांची, देन भारहुट एंड देवर कोठार. देवरकोठार इज फाउंड आई थिंक 20-25 ईयर्स अगो, इट्स डिस्कवर्ड न्यू स्तूपा ऑफ मौर्य नेरा. ठीक है, इन 1980s अर्ली 90s समटाइम. दिस इज जस्ट अक्रॉस द यूपी बॉर्डर इन MP. सो बैराट, सांची, बारकुट, देवरकोठार, विल सी दिस फोर स्तूपास, नॉट इन द सिक्वेंस बट दिस सी फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द रीजनल सेंट्रल इंडियन स्तूपा कैसे थे, सम ऑफ देम मौर्य, सम ऑफ देम लेटर ऑन. देवरकोठार ओवर हियर इन MP, यस, बॉर्डर यहाँ से जाती है, बॉर्डर के जस्ट यहाँ पे है वो. ठीक है, आई डोंट नो द डिस्ट्रिक्ट, याद नहीं मुझे यार. हाँ, सी आई हैव, व्हाट आई हैव डन हियर इज बैराट, सांची, बारहुट, देवरकोठार, आई ऑलवेज गो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. सो फर्स्ट इज बैराट, देन सांची, देन बारहुट, देन देवरकोठार. सो इट विल बिकम इजियर फॉर यू नेक्स्ट टाइम वेन यू सी द स्लाइड, डोंट वरी. सिक्वेंस फ्रॉम वेस्ट टू ईस्ट इज द सिक्वेंस ऑफ नेम्स ओवर हियर. हाँ हाँ, भारूट इज MP, यस, भारूट इज MP. ठीक है, कम टू द ग्रेट सांची स्तूपा. सांची स्तूपा इज सांची कॉम्प्लेक्स, अगेन यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. इट हैज मेनी स्तूपास, ग्रेट स्तूपा नंबर 1, 2, 3, 5 एक्सेट्रा. इट्स अ टॉप व्यू एंड द ग्रेट स्तूपा, सम ऑफ द स्तूपास हैव मौर्यन एरा का कोर, बट मोस्ट ऑफ देम वेर बिल्ट ड्यूरिंग शुंगा एंड सातवाहना एरा, दैट इज द पॉइंट. ठीक है, द स्तूपा नंबर 3 has the relics of two of Buddha's main disciples, Sariputta and Mahamoggallana. Sanchi has many stupas, it is not the only great one stupa. Okay, stupa number 3 has relics of Sariputta and Mahamoggallana. Stupa number 2 is known as the birthplace of Jataka narratives, because in the time of Ashoka or Maurya, you don't see narrative panels of sculptures in which you have various human figures and telling some story. No, that is not there. We have animals and some human forms, individual of them. In the major way, the Jataka stories in narrative format on surface started being sculpted after Maurya in Shunga era. And the oldest one available ever is Stupa number 2 in Sanchi. And what we know generally in photos is Stupa number 1, the great stupa, Mahastupa. Theek hai? We'll see the sculpture of them in sculpture quite in detail, don't worry. This is just architecture wala part. This is the view from far away. On the hillock, you have the Sanchi Stupa. Great Sanchi Stupa. So, this is Anda, Harmika, Yashti, Chhatri, Vedika, Torana, Medhi, Sopan. Good enough? Theek hai? Simple hai? The great interesting thing is that you look at this finely ornamented sculpture in the backdrop of very rough and plain Anda. So, Anda was not carved in central India. If you want to have that fine aesthetic carved Anda as well, go to South India. South Indian stupas are known to have the entire sculpture on their Anda as well. But in central India, Anda is generally bland. But you have very fine carving on Torana and Vedikas. Differences, regional differences. दिस इज सैक्रीफाइस ऑफ वेसंतरा, अगेन जातक कथा ऑन ग्रेट स्तूपा नंबर 1। ये अब कहानी है, कहानी गोज लाइक दिस, कि एक राजा था वेसंतर नाम का, एंड दिस राजा स्टार्टेड डोनेटिंग एवरी, ही वॉज द कर्ण ऑफ बुद्धिज्म, सब दान कर देगा, अपना घर दान कर दिया, राज्य दान कर दिया, पति पत्नी सब कुछ, बीवी बाल बच्चे हाथी घोड़े संपत्ति धन महल सब दान कर दिया। भिक्खू हो गया अंत में, बहुत गरीब हो गया, परेशान हो गया, भगवान बाद में खुश हो गए, उसको सारा लौटा दिया। इतनी स्टोरी है, बट द थिंग इज दिस स्टोरी इज ट्राइंग टू से समथिंग दैट यू हैव टू गिव आर्म्स फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ रिलीजन, डोनेट करो, डोनेट करोगे तो आपका भला होगा, भगवान भी खुश होगा, ठीक है। बिकॉज द सांची स्तूपा वॉज बिल्ट बाय डोनेशन ऑफ हंड्रेड्स ऑफ पीपल। नाउ कम टू अगेन पेज नंबर 5 ओवर हियर, पेज नंबर 5 इन द बिगिनिंग वी हैव अ ब्रैकेट, द डोनर्स ऑफ सांची स्तूपा, अराउंड 1,000 स्मॉल डोनर्स इंक्लूडिंग सम 200 वुमेन। बाय द वे, व्हेन वी से इन इंडिया वी डिड नॉट हैव प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स टू वुमेन, औरतें यहाँ पे डोनेट कर रही है, 200 वुमेन, अमंग देम द नन बुद्ध पालिता फंडेड दिस रिमार्केबल स्तूपा, इट्स स्केल एंड आर्टिस्टिक रिचनेस बियरिंग विटनेस टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एफिशियंसी एंड कंसिडरेबल रिसोर्सेस ऑफ द मोनेस्टिक ऑर्डर। मतलब संघ जो थे वो भी अमीर थे, वरना कैसे इतना बना पाए। ऑब्वियसली वो बिजनेस करे ना करे, दे आर टेकिंग डोनेशंस, दे आर चैनलाइजिंग मनी फ्रॉम हियर टू देयर, सो दे आर ऑल्सो बिग इंस्टीट्यूशंस, यू कैन कॉल देम नॉन प्रॉफिट इंस्टीट्यूशंस, बट स्टिल। हाउएवर द कॉस्ट ऑफ द डेकोरेशन ऑफ द गेटवे तोरणास वॉज बॉर्न बाय 11 मेजर डोनर्स, वी नो देयर नेम्स एज वेल। जेनरोसिटी दान वॉज रेज टू द लेवल ऑफ अ सैक्रमेंट इन बुद्धिज्म, धर्म का सबसे बड़ा काम दान है, इंस्टिल्ड थ्रू द पॉपुलर स्टोरी ऑफ प्रिंस वेसांतरा, आई जस्ट शोड यू ओवर हियर। अमंग द डोनर्स एट सांची वेयर द आइवरी वर्कर्स फ्रॉम द नियर बाय टाउन विदिशा हु कार्व्ड द डिटेल्स ऑफ द गेटवेज एज एन एक्ट ऑफ पायटी, बट द ओवरवेलमिंग एविडेंस इज दैट इन एंशियंट इंडिया आर्किटेक्ट्स कॉल्ड सूत्रधार, मेसन्स, स्टोन वर्कर्स, स्कल्प्टर्स वेयर प्रोफेशनल्स हु अंडरटूक रिलीजियस प्रोजेक्ट्स रिगार्डलेस ऑफ देयर ओन रिलीजन, अ फिनोमेनॉन सीन थ्रू आउट इंडियन हिस्ट्री। इफ एंशियंट इंडियन आर्ट एंड आर्किटेक्चर वेयर एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ प्रोफाउंड फेथ, दिस वॉज मेनली द फेथ ऑफ द पैटर्न एंड नॉट नेसेसरिली ऑफ द क्राफ्ट्समैन। एनी वे, दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्तूपास ऑफ सांची, एंड इफ यू गो एंड ट्राई टू रिकंस्ट्रक्ट द एंटायर कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑफ सांची स्तूपा, वी हैव वेरियस बिल्डिंग्स ओवर हियर। दिस टेम्पल का अभी भी पचा कुचा टुकड़ा है, विल सी दिस वन इन वेरियस टेम्पल्स, टेम्पल आर्किटेक्चर का देखेंगे तो उसमें देखेंगे इसको, ठीक है। यू हैव अशोकास कॉलम सपोजिटली, अनदर व्यू, दिस इज तोरण एंड स्तूप। कम टू नेक्स्ट स्तूपा नंबर 2 इन सांची, दिस स्तूपा नंबर 2 इज फार अवे फ्रॉम द मेन कॉम्प्लेक्स, लुक्स लाइक दिस, एंड इट ऑल्सो हैज स्कल्पचर, दैट इज दिस वन। And this is the beginning in India of the Jataka Katha representing on this sculpture. Yahan pe shuruaat hui hai. It is older than this stupa. Ye stupa ka bahar ka part baad mein banaya gaya hai. Theek hai? Then you have next place in central India, Barhat. Now we don't have that stupa existing anymore. That stupa is gone. At one point of time it was a huge great stupa, lekin jaise India mein hota hai, jo Harappa mein hua tha. Local people wanted to build something, so they got the stones and bricks from there and they built their own thing. Harappa, pata hai kya hua tha na? Why we found and lost Harappa and Mohenjo-daro? British were building railway lines, and for railway lines they wanted local contractors to bring them raw material. Niche dalne ke liye tukde chahiye, ite chahiye, patthar chahiye. So local logon ko contract de diya ki bhai aap 10 truck, aap 50 truck, 100 truck patthar le aao, ite le aao. We want to lay the railways. तो लोग को लोग कहाँ से लाएंगे, खदान में जाएंगे पत्थर निकालेंगे लाल करेंगे। सो दे फाउंड दिस ह्यूज स्टोर हाउस ऑफ ईटें, बनी बची रेडीमेड ईटें, दैट इज हड़प्पा मोहनजोदड़ो। तो बहुत से लेबर लगा दिए, चलो निकालो ईटें, निकालो रेलवे बनानी है, ठीक है। सो लॉट ऑफ द ब्रिक वर्क ऑफ हड़प्पा एंड मोहनजोदड़ो इज लॉस्ट टू रेलवे कंस्ट्रक्शन एक्टिविटी। इन अमरावती देर वॉज जागीरदार ओवर देर और सम जमींदार, यू वॉन्ट टू बिल्ड दिस पैलेस। बोला पैलेस के लिए मुझे ईटें बनानी है, आई वॉन्ट चारकोल, कहाँ मिलेगा। He found this Amravati Stupa. It's a long story. I'm taking just one section. Amravati Stupa. And he saw there are a lot of marble structures. इसको जला के चारकोल बनाते हैं, चलो। तो सब लेके चारकोल बना के उसने अपना महल बनवा दिया। तो ये भारत देश है, नो रिगार्ड फॉर हिस्ट्री एट ऑल। आई हैव पर्सनली सीन पीपल बर्निंग, उनके फैमिली में कागज 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 सदियों पुराने कागज फैमिली में आते हैं, टेकिंग दिस कागज बर्निंग देम इन टू फायर, बाथरूम का नहाने का पानी गर्म करने के लिए। आंखों से देखा है मैंने, आप रो पड़ोगे। तो दिस स्तूपा इज गॉन, बट दिस इज मी फ्रॉम 5-7 years ago इन कलकत्ता म्यूजियम। सो द पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस स्तूपा आर प्रिजर्व्ड। सो दिस इज अ बारहट स्तूपा इन कलकत्ता म्यूजियम, ठीक है। इट इज हियर, यू सी मौर्यन स्कल्पचर, सुंगा स्कल्पचर, तोरणा एटसेट्रा। सो इट इज वेरी मच लाइक सांची का स्तूप, ठीक है। वी हैव वेदिका, ये स्कल्पचर ओवर हियर एज वेल, ऑन हियर एज वेल, हियर मेडलियन दे आर कॉल्ड एज। विल सी द स्कल्पचर इन डिटेल, डोंट वरी अबाउट स्कल्पचर। द स्ट्रक्चर यू हैव, यू गेट अक्वाइंटेड विद द लोकेशंस एंड स्ट्रक्चर्स। दिस नेम विल कीप अपियरिंग अगेन एंड अगेन इन अवर एंटायर सीरीज। ये बैराट स्तूप, इतना ही बचा है, कुछ नहीं बचा, ठीक है। एंशियंट विराटनगर, द कैपिटल ऑफ मत्स्य देश, एंड हियर वी हैव फाउंड नॉट ओनली स्तूपा बट ऑल्सो अशोकन इंस्क्रिप्शन। And it is the only Ashokan inscription in which Ashoka, there are few inscriptions of Ashoka like Sanchi and Bairat where Ashoka directly talks to only Buddhist monks and not to people. Humko padhte nahi hai apne syllabus mein. So Bairat inscription mein Ashoka ne, okay, artistic reconstruction of stupa looks like this. Perhaps it might have looked like this based on other evidences. Theek hai, so do level ka hai. Some structure, some sculpture yahan pe. Andar jaane ka raasta bhi hai. It is just a guess kyunki yahan pe we have two levels like this. Your entry also. So this is the possible reconstruction of stupa Bairat. And this is the Ashokan edict of Bairat, in which Ashoka tells people what to read and what to read in Buddhism. So he has given a list of Buddhist books for people to understand Dhamma. He says, it is known to you, sirs, how great is my reverence and faith in the Buddha, the Dhamma and the Sangha, Tri Ratna. Whatsoever, sirs, has been spoken by the blessed Buddha, all that is quite well spoken. But, sirs, what would indeed appear to me? Thus the true Dhamma will be of long duration that I feel bound to declare. And then the following expositions of the Dhamma, sirs, the Vinaya, Samukasa, etc. has given the entire list of the books that monks and people should read to understand Buddhist Dhamma. So when we say ki Ashoka ka dhamma was different than dhamma of Buddha, it is true. But Ashoka was Buddhist himself. So we have a majority of edicts talking about Ashokan dhamma, and we have some edicts like Sanchi edict, it is called Schism edict, in which Ashoka is directly intervening into the internal sectarian strife between Buddhism. He is saying, no, ye nahi karna, wo karna hai, main decision dunga. Theek hai? And this is one edict, Bairat edict, in which Ashoka is saying, Buddhism janne ke liye, aap kaun si kitabe padho. ठीक है, हाँ। कम टू देवर कोठार इन एमपी, जस्ट स्तूपा लाइक दिस, वेरी सिंपल, डाउन टू अर्थ, मोर एन एरा स्तूपा, ठीक है। दिस इज लाइक न्यू फाउंड स्तूपास, 20-25 years अगो ओनली, नॉट वेरी ओल्ड। कम टू साउथ इंडिया, वी हैव कवर्ड सेंट्रल इंडिया, कम टू साउथ इंडिया। सी आई एम पर्पजफुली गोइंग दिस वे बिकॉज दिस इज ऑल्सो द मैप दैट वी फॉलो वेन वी सी स्कल्पचर। सेंट्रल इंडिया मथुरा स्कल्पचर, South Amaravati sculpture, and then we'll go to Gandhar, North West sculpture. Similarly, stupa also is original. ठीक है, we have Nagarjuna Sagar, this one, Digaya Peta, Amaravati, and Chotlakonda. The four places. Primarily for us, important is Amaravati stupa, but I have just added a few more to give you idea. Satvahan ka second half happened in this era, and after Satvahanas, we have Ikshvakus coming up. So Nagarjuna Konda, Ikshvakus, Amaravati, Satvahanas. Can I wait for a moment? This is a very rich delta of Krishna and Godavari. Krishna Godavari delta over here. So very fertile place, very fertile. And you see it being a nucleus of many kingdoms and dynasties over centuries. चले आगे, Amaravati, city of immortals. Here you see, again, this stupa doesn't exist. It is destroyed. Some of it exists in some parts in India. Some of it goes outside India. There is called something called Iliad marbles. We'll see later. Iliad is a person who got the marble sculptures from here and put it into a museum in London. So if you want to see this stupa, go to London. ठीक है. अरे यार, ये इतिहास में बहुत बड़ी दिक्कत है. टू गेट होल्ड ऑफ प्राइमरी रिसोर्सेज, वॉट एवर यू हैव इज डिस्ट्रॉयड. वॉट एवर इज नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड, पीपल डोंट वॉन्ट टू शेयर. एंड वॉट एवर इज अवेलेबल, इट इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूट अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड. अ पुअर डिसेंट हिस्टोरियन हु इज अ प्रोफेसर इन सम यूनिवर्सिटी कैन नॉट गो एवरीवेयर एंड स्टडी फॉर इन ओरिजिन. तो स्कॉलरशिप चाहिए. तो रिसर्च बहुत प्रॉब्लमेटिक होता है इतिहास में. इन मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट्स ऑल्सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सेस मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट्स. एनीवे, तो this is how the stupa must have looked like. We have a plaque and we have artistic reconstruction. Here you see ki ye sab hai, andar bhi ja sakte ho. You have these five pillars and this is a khasiyat, a speciality of South Indian pillars. The torana back over there, and near stupa you have five pillars, and on this stupa you have sculptural activity as well and narratives. Here also you see five pillars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are five pillars of unequal height. They are called, okay, this is a photo from 1880s. Some structures of stupa were just lying around like this, found during excavation. This is what remained. ठीक है. एंड वन ऑफ द बेस्ट स्तूपाज एवर, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल एक्सक्विजिटली कार्व्ड स्तूपाज ऑफ मार्बल. एंड टुडे इट इज लाइक दिस. एंड दिस इज वन अनदर रिकंस्ट्रक्शन बाय आई थिंक जेम्स फर्ग्यूसन. हाँ, जेम्स फर्ग्यूसन, राइट. इन नागार्जुन सागर यू हैव अनदर स्तूपा. एंड दीज आर दिस फाइव आयका पिलर्स. हियर वी हैव स्तूपाज अ वैरायटी ऑफ फॉर्म्स. वी हैव समटाइम्स हॉलो स्तूपाज, समटाइम्स स्तूपन स्वस्तिक वाला फॉर्म, समटाइम्स यू हैव स्तूपा विथ आयका पिलर्स. तो स्तूपा नीड नॉट बी ओनली सर्कुलर ऑल द टाइम. इन साउथ वी हैव लॉट ऑफ वैरायटी. ठीक है. वेर यू स्माइलिंग ऑल द टाइम सर? ये पांच पिलर जो है ना, इनको आयका पिलर्स बोलते हैं. आई डोंट नो द पर्पस, इट इज नॉट क्लियर.
बट
नो, दे आर ऑल्सो सेम. Same, same. These all are Ayaka pillars. It's called as Ayaka pillars. I'm just showing you a artistic photo over here and real photo over here, whatever remains today in Nagarjunakonda. Thotlakonda Mahastupa, again entirely brick stupa. It's near the seashore. You can see now the base is little contracted, but you still have harmika and etc. Now, what happened last year? Barish aayi, khatam. So the thing that survived for thousands of years, now in front of our eyes getting destroyed like this. I don't know whether they have restored it. I might suspect that they have restored it, but I don't know. But you see the stupa from inside is full. Okay, there is nothing inside like that, where you can go. Thotla Gonda, are you? Naksha dikhaya tha na? Thotlakonda, Vizag. Now you have third region, the region where we see Gandhar sculpture, a region where we have influence of Central Asia and Hellenistic trends coming due to Indo-Greeks. This is the region. You have this India, Jammu Kashmir over here. You have Pakistan wala part and Afghanistan wala part. This is actually one seamless region geographically. We'll start with, these are the five places we'll see. Guldara near Kabul, Hadda in Afghanistan, then Kanishka Stupa in Peshawar. Peshawar ka mool naam Kanishkapur tha. Peshawar, Kanishka built a huge stupa over there, very historically important stupa which doesn't exist. Then Takht-e-Bahi is today World Heritage Site, UNESCO ki. And then you have in the outskirts of Islamabad, Takshashila. It has various stupas of its own. One of the famous is Dharmarajika Stupa. It is also again UNESCO World Heritage Site. Theek hai. This is, see, Mazar-e-Sharif, you go from here, come down to here and come to Indus. It is trade route, ancient trade route from kafilas have gone and come for thousands of years. Yehi rasta hai wo, entry point of India. Theek hai. This Kabul and Kandahar, from Kabul you have here Khyber Pass, Kandahar you have Gomal Pass, or vice versa. Nahi sahi hai, Khyber Pass, Gomal Pass. So these twin cities, अकबर यूज टू कॉल देम, ये इंडिया के दो द्वार है. इन आईन अकबरी इट इज रिटन, दीज आर द टू गेटवेज ऑफ इंडिया. ट्रेड यहाँ से होता था। तख्ते बाही फोर्थ वन ना, 1, 2, 3, 4 दिस वन। दिस इज द तख्ते बाही इन खैबर पख्तूनख्वा, राइट? नाउ वी डोंट हैव इट एग्जिस्टिंग देयर। इट इज द फर्स्ट सेंचुरी सी यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट ऑफ कुशाना टाइम, इंडो ग्रीक टाइम, आफ्टर इंडो ग्रीक कुशाना टाइम, कुशानास। सो अगेन इट्स आर्टिस्टिक रिकंस्ट्रक्शन वुड बी लाइक दिस। यू हैव नाउ स्तूपस गेटिंग नैरोवर इन वेरियस टेरेसेस एंड लेयर्स एंड इज गेटिंग एक्सटेंडेड। नाउ स्तूपा स्ट्रक्चर इज चेंजिंग ग्रेजुअली, यू नोटिस दैट। देन यू हैव धर्मराजिका स्तूप इन तक्षशिला, सेकंड सेंचुरी इज यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट। अगेन सम ऑफ द माउंट स्टिल एग्जिस्ट, मोस्ट ऑफ इट इज गॉन। देन यू गो टू गुलडारा, हियर यू हैव स्तूपा इंटरेस्टिंगली विथ स्क्वेयर बेस एंड देन ऑन द टॉप यू हैव सर्कल एंड देन अगेन सिलेंडर एंड देन अंडर, सो अंडर सिलेंडर स्क्वेयर, सो यू हैव वैरायटी ऑफ फॉर्म। सेकंड इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग ओवर हियर इज यू कैन सी द टाइल्स, दिस टाइलिंग इज अ स्पेसिफिक इंडो ग्रीक स्टाइल ऑफ ऑर्नामेंटेशन। सामने ऊपर टाइल लगा देंगे अलग अलग तरीके से, ठीक है? सो कुशाण एरा नियर काबुल, इट इज दिस वन इन वन फोटो, ठीक है? एंड देन द मोस्ट फेमस कनिष्का स्तूप, इट यूज टू बी 600 चाइनीज फीट, इट इज एट दैट टाइम कॉल्ड एज द वंडर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। व्हेन ह्यूएन सांग केम टू इंडिया ही सेड आई हैव बॉर्न देयर, आई सीन द स्तूपा, वहाँ पे भूत रहते हैं, बहुत बड़ा है, कुछ कुछ लिखा है उसने। पॉइंट इज इट यूज टू बी, ही इज अ पर्सन स्टैंडिंग, यू कैन सी द रिलेटिव हाइट दैट वॉज गिवन बाई हिस्टोरिकल पर्सनैलिटीज, कितना ऊंचा है ये। इट इज गॉन, बट इट ऑल्सो कंटेन एलिमेंट्स ऑफ बुद्धा। ये वन प्लेस कॉल हड्डा, यू सी वेरियस टेरेसेस एंड स्कल्पचर ऑन ह्यूमन फॉर्म। सो वेन यू सी दिस ह्यूमन स्कल्पचर ऑन स्तूपा, वॉट यू सी, ओ कुशाना एरा में बुद्धिज्म वॉज महायान बुद्धिज्म, राइट? बुद्धा हैज बिकम अ पर्सन टू वेनरेट, नो मोर सिम्बॉलिक बुद्धिज्म ऑफ हिनयान। वी हैव सीन हिनयान महायान, नो, इट इज डेफिनेटली महायान स्तूपा, इट कैन नॉट बी हिनयान स्तूपा, राइट मैम? एंड यू हैव इन स्वात वैली, स्वात वैली एक्चुअली इज एन अनएक्सप्लोर्ड एरिया वेयर यू हैव हंड्रेड एंड हंड्रेड ऑफ स्तूपा। वन ब्रांच ऑफ द सिल्क रूट वेंट फ्रॉम नॉर्थ ऑफ कश्मीर थ्रू स्वात डायरेक्टली केम इन टू इंडिया एंड नॉट थ्रू अफगानिस्तान। दैट ब्रांच थ्रू खैबर पास एंड ऑल, खैबर पास नहीं, क्या बोलते उसको, आई फॉरगॉट द नेम, दैट वन ट्रेड रूट विच इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट बट इट वॉज वेरी पॉपुलर बिकॉज इट वॉज शॉर्टेस्ट रूट एट दैट टाइम। तो बिकॉज इट रिमेन आइसोलेटेड फॉर सेंचुरीज, मेनी ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर्स हैव सर्वाइव्ड ओवर देयर, बाकी जाकर खत्म हो गए धीरे धीरे। तो यू कैन फाइंड हंड्रेड ऑफ स्तूपा इन स्वात वैली इवन टूडे एंड दे हैव देयर ओन डबल डोम्स एज वेल लाइक दिस, ठीक है? एंड कम बैक टू इंडिया, फॉरगेट द गांधार रीजन, वी हैव सीन अमरावती रीजन, बिफोर दैट वी सॉ सेंट्रल इंडिया एंड वी ऑल्सो सी गांधार रीजन। कम बैक टू इंडिया, वॉट वॉज हैपनिंग इन इंडिया आफ्टर मौर्य एंड कुशाना एरा, हाउ द स्तूपा आर्किटेक्चर डेवलप्ड ग्रेजुअली। You have this Ajanta, as I said initially, inside Chaitya, it is Chaitya because it has stupa inside. It has stupa inside Chaitya, cave number 19, Ajanta. And now you see Buddha incarnate sculpture over there. So it is Mahayana cave, it cannot be Hinayana cave. This is Chaitya, inside it there is a stupa. And now it is not a constructed stupa, it is a rock cut stupa. The, so far all the stupas we had seen were built in stone or bricks. Mostly bricks, northwest largely stones. Here we have rock cut stupa. Stupas were, by the way, not only specific to Buddhists. We have many evidences, although not very dominant, but we have many evidences which say stupas were also built by Jainas. ठीक है, ये याद रखना. Anyway, so you have this thing, the upper thing getting bigger and bigger. You have come back to UP and Bihar. The original heartland of Buddhism, Chaukhandi stupa in Gupta era between Gaya and Sarnath. See the stupa, the mound is actually eroded, it must have been like this earlier, it doesn't exist anymore, but we have this stupa. The place where Buddha met his disciples between Gaya and Sarnath, so Gaya mein Buddha got enlightenment, he went to Sarnath to give the first speech. In between we have this Chaukhandi stupa where he met his followers for the first time, theek hai, Bhallika and Tapassu. we talked about them. Then come to Bihar again, Kesariya Stup, built again during Gupta. It is the place वहाँ पे Buddha started to go in the end of his life. People said कि आप मत जाओ, मैं बूढ़ा हो गया, उम्र हो गई, मैं जाना पड़ेगा. तो उस समय कुछ बातें चल रही, इट्स अ वेरी फेमस महापरिनिर्वाण सूत्र इन विच ही सेज वन प्लेस कि इन द अर्लियर लाइफ आई वॉज बोर्न एज चक्रवर्ती राजा इन दिस लैंड. ही डिक्लेयर्ड दैट एट दिस प्लेस केसरिया स्तूप. इट इज अगेन अ न्यू फाउंड स्तूप. ओके, मोहम्मद करके एक आगरा सर्कल के प्रमुख थे, ASI के. बिफोर ही बिकेम हेड ऑफ ASI सर्कल ऑफ आगरा सर्कल ऑफ ASI, ही इज द वन हू ब्रॉट दिस इनटू लाइट इन 1990s. केसरिया स्तूप आइकॉन. नालंदा स्तूप तो है ही, नालंदा स्तूप अगेन यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. एंड यू सी डेवलपमेंट ऑफ स्तूपा आउटसाइड इंडिया एज वेल. दिस इज जेतवन स्तूपा अनुराधापुर इन सिलोन, दैट इज श्रीलंका. इट इज अगेन अ ह्यूज स्तूपा, यू कैन सी द पीपल ओवर हियर, ह्यूज स्तूपा. इट इज यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. अनुराधापुर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कल्चरल प्लेस एंड पॉलिटिकल प्लेस इन श्रीलंका फॉर सेंचुरीज. यू हैव सोमापुरी बिहार, पाल एरा, UPSC क्वेश्चन दिस ईयर, ईस्ट इंडिया. इट इज ऑल्सो यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. इट इज ऑल्सो स्तूपा एंड महाविहार, सोमापुरी. पता है ना, इन पालेले यू हैव 4 or 5 इंपॉर्टेंट स्तूपा, नालंदा, उदंतपुरी, विक्रमशिला, सोमापुरी एंड वन मोर. ठीक, देन यू कम टू जावा, बोरोबुदुर, इंडोनेशिया. नाउ यू बिकम स्तूपा बिकमिंग मोर टेरेस्ट एंड मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स. ठीक है, हियर यू सी लॉट ऑफ स्मॉल स्तूपाज. सो इट्स अ स्तूपा बिल्ड ऑफ मेनी स्तूपाज, कॉम्प्लिकेटेड स्ट्रक्चर एंड अ लॉट ऑफ मूर्तिज एज वेल ओवर देयर. दिस इज स्तूपा, स्मॉल स्तूपा, डेकोरेशन स्तूपा आउटसाइड द पैलेस ऑफ दलाई लामा. दिस इज अ पैलेस व्हेन ही लेफ्ट इन 1950s, जब भाग के आए थे चाइना से. बिफोर दैट एज अ चाइल्ड ही यूज्ड टू लिव इन दिस पैलेस इन ल्हासा इन तिब्बत. उसका आज का फोटो है ये, पटोला पैलेस. एंड इट इज द पैलेस वेयर दलाई लामाज फॉर सेंचुरीज हैव लिव्ड. उसके बाहर का स्तूप है ये, हिरोशिमा आफ्टर एटम बॉम्ब पीस पैगोडा. दिस इज स्तूपा इन हिरोशिमा एट द वेरी प्लेस जहाँ पे एटम बॉम्ब गिरा था. That's all. I think I have hopefully given you a rough idea of what stupa architecture means. Symbols, variety, forms, purposes, donation, religion, pattern, structural change. ठीक है, we'll stop here. Tomorrow we'll begin with rock cut architecture, Chaitya and Vihar. Thank you.